really good. This is like a little trainer with a reconnaissance.
What's behind it? Look, Steve, they left you a golf cart to take around.
Where is it?
Right here.
What you always see around, what do you call it? Sebring. That they fly in, fly out, remember?
Uh-huh.
And these are the two main bombers of the Second World War. See the turret in the bottom? Look at it. This was the first bomber that made B-17 that this country made. Boeing made it. It's a B-17. It looks bigger in the movies, doesn't it?
I don't know. It looks pretty big to me.
It's filled. Tail gunner used to be in the back by himself. He had to come down by himself. No one else was back here. He'd sit back here the whole mission and make sure nobody comes. So the Germans used to go after this guy first. Not many of them lived because then they could come in behind it. If they can kill the tail gunner, there's nothing else that could swing around to the back, you know? So that was the worst job to have, flying one of these. See, this guy couldn't turn around because he could shoot off his own tail. So you get on each side, you block it, you hide yourself for the attack coming in. Yeah? Well, look at that, huh? That is amazing. And these things only did like 200 miles an hour or whatever. They're flying over. And they're not pressurized, so you could only go like I think about right around 10, 20,000 feet they had the wheel on. Amazing, huh?
Yes.
Look at the motor. This is the turbocharger. That thing was spinning to pump air into the motor to give it more power. Look at that. Just air-cooled engines, like motorcycle engines. Just air-cooled. No radiators, no nothing. Yeah. What do you need? This here, these were both at the beginning of the war. This is a consolidated, they used to call it the flying boxcar because you can see it's nothing sleek about it. It's just like a big car, and it was made to drop a lot of bombs, and it was made cheap. They were trying to crank them out, you know? So this is consolidated, I think B-24 is what they call it. This was B-17. And then this was the next generation. By the end of the war, just before the end, like 44, they came out with this. This was the improvement for these two. These two were the first we started the war with. Then they went to this, and this was the one that could go long distance overseas and carry a payload from islands all the way to Japan because they needed range. So this was a whole different deal. Very expensive, a lot of problems with this plane. Making it. They wanted to, Congress wanted to kill it because it was too high tech, too much crap, you know? This is a different one. This is the B-29. And this sucker is our heavy bomber. This was the improvement over that. See, the Super Fortress.
B-29. So they kind of have them in chronological order?
Right. They went from that to this. Made this one. This was the super one. This is pressurized now. You could wear regular clothes. The captain and the pilots could all be in there. They didn't have to wear the cumbersome outfit and freezing their ass off. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
It was like a massive improvement over these. These you had to wear flight jackets, had to have your oxygen strapped to your face, was cumbersome. This here was the first time it became like an airliner. And it would, you know, you could just be in short sleeves or whatever, flying and be comfortable for the long distance. This is what it evolved to, the B-29. And this could do 358 miles an hour. The old B-17 is only like 200 and something. These are the planes that they took off and bombed Tokyo, Doolittle, off the carrier deck. This is what they took off, like 21 of these took off from a carrier deck. And carriers were small, like the USS Midway. Imagine having 21 of these stuck on that deck where we were in San Diego, and they have to go, they only got the distance to take off from the back to the front, and they're backed up. You believe that?
Yeah.
This is what they took off from. When they show that old video, this is what these huge planes took off. The captain of the ship started going, you know, full speed into the wind to try to give them as much advantage. You know what I mean? To add speed before they even rolled off the deck. But these are the ones that dropped just a few bombs on Tokyo right after they bombed Pearl Harbor, just to fuck with the Japanese, you know? Just to attack, just to let them know, hey, you know, you're not impervious. We're gonna get you. Yeah. So this thing lasted the whole length of the war. They built those from the beginning to the end of the war. They were making those. It was a medium bomber. They used them in both theaters, in Europe and in This. Douglas Invader. This didn't have a big career. But look at that. You don't see this one all the time. That's the first time I've ever seen one of these. Reconnaissance. They started using these in Vietnam. This ain't even a British plane. This ain't American. This is British. Or no, look, Tornado. This is the American version that they copied it. That's what it is. Yep, 580. But it was a Canberra that they had, and this took it. This is our version, because I know they started building them, just like the Harrier. The Harrier started it. That's a British design. But now it's the AV-8B, which is made by McDonnell Douglas. And the British buy them back from us now, the newer ones. You know? It's weird. The British and the Americans have been doing that for years. And that's a Vulcan, I think. That's the one in the James Bond movie, where the guy goes underwater with it and gets killed. They cut him. You remember Thunderball?
Mm-hmm.
Where he lands a big Delta wing. This is an early atomic bomber for Britain. It's a big Delta wing. Look at that. You don't see that. Avro, I think. This is a British design. Yeah, Vulcan. This had like six people in it. This is a strategic bomber. They're really high tech, made to go really fast, you know? Wasn't lame, like most of ours. Ours, we had the B-52, which was a big, long one. There should be one around here, for sure. But look at that. Massive. And it can only carry two nuclear bombs. That was it. Two. All this bulk. And the crew sits in here, in the back, like halfway down. It's like two levels. And down here, the rest of the crew is. Right? Jamming stuff, all this. This is just for two nuclear bombs. But it was supposed to be supersonic, you know what I mean? They could deliver them, but it could deliver them at supersonic speed. This is a military version of the first plane I ever remember as a baby. Right? This is the Constellation with the three tails. But Constellation, if you take that hump and that bubble off and these tanks off, that's the airliner. That I told you, I saw the engine and the propellers. It's like scared the shit out of me. That's the furthest back I can remember. Right? That's some kind of like AWACS. Those are radars. An early one, no? But that is a constellation. That is a locking different on this. And they have heaters on the props so they don't freeze up. See those things on the front? Those are heaters. So this is made to go into like a hurricane or something. Not get fucked up. Yeah, it's just a weather version of the Super Fortress 50D. It's like a little different. See how it has the big scoop? So they must have put different engines on it. It was a later variant of that one. But you can tell the body's the same. It's just it has big scoops on it. See how the motors? Which it doesn't have on the other one. Maybe it's like a turbo. Vietnam was the last place they started using. They used them up. Because they're only twin engine. Canuck. It's a Canuck. That's what it is. Never even seen that before. I think that's a Viggen. That's Swedish. This one here.
Maybe this is a Swedish. Row.
Yeah, maybe. This is a Saab Viggen or something like that. There it is. What is it? Saab Draken. That's it. The older one. Okay, they make one since then. It's more, yeah, a thing. But that's here, 2.2. Saab. That's pretty neat that they have one. I've never seen one of those in person. Yeah. Look at that.
And those are all bombs hanging down.
Yep. Look at that. That was a fighter. That's a Swedish fighter. What's here? There you go. Fairchild. Fairchild is the company that Victor used to work for on Long Island. Another one, 205 miles an hour. Barely enough, but it hauls a lot of stuff. 60,000 pounds. This place has all the odd airplanes. This is like a B-1B bomber. No, it's all scrap. Yeah. It's like a bottle or something. Look at the tiny wheels on this. To fit in the thin wing. Look at that. Tokyo to London in 8 hours and 35 minutes.